This is the voyage of the starship the Cadillac Bill Show with the Creeping Bent Orchestra as we discover Hamilton, the final frontier. Meet the folks who drive the engine to make this city move. See Anvil, Ginger St. James. Hear from Hamilton Spirits and Cheryl Tice. Meet the Doctor of Creepsville. See Frenchie the Beagle. And Sophie. Hang out with the Hammer City Roller Girls. Jack Pedler.
Gee, Jerry.
I don't know!
Robert Gordon.
Sir, thank you. It's my pleasure being here, man. How you doing?
The Royal Canadian Sea Cadets. And Tom Wilson.
Can we see how low can you go?
Well, I could probably go this low, Bill.
Here now for 2014 on Cable 14, the Cadillac Bill Show. Glittery curtains, fascinating chat about stuff, a stuffed goose, and the Creeping Bent Orchestra. That's about it.
This is better than television. This is the Cadillac Bill Show.
Chaps, we're right now taking off from Biggin Hill Air Base, heading for the coast, destination Berlin. Gonna give those Jerrys a dose of their own medicine. Show them a spot of British firepower, what? Well, over the English Channel right now, the sun is just coming up on a glorious morning. The French coastline coming into sight, a lovely view, I must say. We're all having our morning tea. About the only thing to warm us up here. It's bloody cold. Oh, just past Cherbourg. We're flying rather low, keeping at 2,000 feet so those Jerrys won't see us coming. We're just skimming the treetops. Here we go.
Hello, engineer. Skipper here. Yeah, will you put the revs up, please? Yeah? Okay, keep weaving.
Crossing the Rhine now. Now in Germany. Good show. Those blighters won't know what's coming. Over and out for now. Cheerio.
Hello, Skipper. Hello, Navigator. Half a minute to go. Okay. A lot of searchlights and fighter flares, Skipper.
Yeah, keep on.
Okay, boys. Okay.
We just coming in over Berlin right now. About 9:35 a.m. A beautiful morning. What a lovely city. All just glimmering in the morning sun. I must say, a bit of a shame we have to bomb it. Damn war. But if you could see the mess they made of Coventry, the brutes, we don't feel too bad. Okay, bomb doors open.
Bomb doors open.
Hello, Bombardier. Okay, when you are. Bomb doors open, Bombardier. Bomb's going in a minute.
Steady, chaps. Almost there. Lovely city. There we go. Bombs away.
Bombs away. There goes the cookies.
Lucky, lucky, lucky.
Oh, we've got Lucky going over there. And there go the incendiaries. There goes my bottle.
That should teach them. Show them a bit of what we're made of. Good show, chaps. Okay, now let's hightail it back to Blighty.
Okay. Jettison action now.
Okay, I think they're firing it up. Bomb doors closed.
Bomb doors closed.
Ah, there goes the black guns. Yes, they're blooming firing at us now, the brutes. If we make it back now in one piece, it'll be a spot of okay.
Black coming up, Mick.
Okay, don't shout all at once. Hello, Midgunner. Do you recognize that fighting you turned on?
Yes, Jerry's got us in his crosshairs for sure now. What an absolute bit of bother, this Black. Those Jerrys are making it quite clear they don't appreciate us being here. Well, we're just going to try to slip out of here and sally forth home. A job well done, chaps.
They're firing at us now.
My God. You'd light your fag on any of those. How many searchlights would you call them?
Too many, I reckon.
We can make it out of this mess. A pint all round on me. Oh, there goes a close one.
No.
Okay, I think they're firing it up.
Okay, a bit of bother. Just blasted off our tail flap. Now that's not cricket, what? Okay, I gotta sign off now. A bit of tricky flying to do. Limp this bird back home. Over and out.
Okay,
had a bit of bother from Jerry. He managed to knock out all our hydraulics, but we're still in the air and might make it home scot-free. Heading home with a tail flap shot off. If I can just make it back to Biggin Hill Airfield and then offer a pint if I make it. Tally-ho. Blast. Didn't quite make the Dover cliff. Managed to parachute out before the crash. I'm about to touch down. Can't talk now. Cheerio. I'm at a payphone in Southampton. I just ditched my lank in the drink and I'll hitchhike from Dover to Sussex for a cup of tea with the Duke of Beaufort and back to Biggin Hill and see what Bomber Command has lined up for another mission to Germany. Apparently, a squadron commander has named it Operation Bailout without a parachute. Sounds marvelous, I said. Count me in. We'll really catch Jerry with his trousers down, by gum. Also, I do hope you've got some bandages. I seem to have caught a bit of shrapnel in my shoulder and lost a leg in the ordeal. Damn war. Anyway, gotta go. Cheerio. Tally-ho, chap. See you in Berlin.
So that was Wing Commander Bill and his bombing mission over Berlin. Some fun stuff there. It's always nice to make fun and have light of a miserable event such as World War II.
Everybody loves a good bombing.
They do.
Deep down inside, they want to see things bombed.
And the good thing about World War II, you can make fun of it because it had a good outcome. You know, we won. You've been to Berlin, haven't you?
Yeah, well, I was in Berlin, West Berlin, actually, when the wall was still up. And I seen the Spandau Prison where the first Allied bomb had hit, but didn't explode. And they sort of set that up as a monument to WW2. But Berlin is a very cool town. Yeah.
Thank God for freedom.
Absolutely. And actually, a lot of Europe is basically
destroyed from World War II. You know, it's like a lot of the old buildings are all gone, and certainly London is, and Germany is not much historic buildings left in Germany, that's for sure.
Well, it's funny, in London, if you're driving through some older parts of London, you'll notice that you'll have these old Victorian homes, and then suddenly you'll have this sort of apartment building there. And you could tell that that apartment building there, that's where a V1 or worse hit.
I was, of course, when I was a little boy in England, all of the bomb craters had all been cleaned up by that point. But anybody a generation before me who grew up in England during the 50s, a lot of the devastation and the bomb, you know, the bomb craters were all still there, right? Through.
They cleaned them up.
Well, right up until the late 50s, there were still bombed out buildings, the remains of World War II.
Any modern city, if you see a large hill in the middle of the city, that's where all the rubble from some of these devastated cities went. Made a great big hill out of it, and then they built new.
What a magnificent t-shirt there you've got there, Mike.
Thank you.
Look at that, good stuff. And actually, I brought along something to show you all. Speaking of me growing up in England, here, my mum gave me this. This was the jacket I wore when I was 3 years old.
That's the jacket that the little boy wore in the movie The Omen.
Look at that. Get a shot of the beautiful velvet pockets, eh?
Yeah. Take a look at the front of that, Bill.
Oh, double-breasted.
Can you see them in the mirrors?
Let me have a look.
There you go.
Beautiful.
Very, very lovely. Very Croydon-like.
That reminds me of Croydon-like. John F. Kennedy Jr.'s jacket.
Oh, actually, Croydon is right near where I'm from. And Kate Moss is from Croydon. So there you go. There you go. Hey, Mike, see if we can put this on the goose.
It's either Damien's. Or JFK Jr.'s.
There you go. Pop that on the goose then, Mike. Okay, so now
Good night, goose.
Yeah. No, put it right there. There we go. You get a shot of this, Dan?
Terrific.
Excellent. You know who we haven't seen in a while? The little dog, Sophie. Let's go see what Sophie's wearing now. Here we go. Right in there. There she is. Okay, lovely little Sophie. And of course, Sophie's there on the Bookmobile. When I was working on the Bookmobile, Luann would bring out Sophie in every week. She'd be in a different outfit. That's why I was filming her. However, a few years ago, I made a little film about the Bookmobile. And this film I'm going to show for you guys. First time it's debut on television, and it's kind of old technology. The camera I used, this was 3 years ago, so it wasn't the high-tech, fancy, sophisticated equipment we're using now.
Well, you know, there's a certain warmth to earlier technology.
It's not that old.
Well, it's, I remember 3 years ago, it was a lot warmer.
Okay, technology. Yeah, all right. But yes, this has some beautiful, warm, grainy footage of the Bookmobile, and it's also got some pretty cool old 1950s footage of Hamilton. So Let's check this out. Here we go, the Bookmobile little film from a few years ago.
This is the main public library. It has a convenient site in the center of the city, and the dignity of its classic lines has not diminished with the years. Within its walls, it is as modern and functional as it is possible to make a building which is nearly half a century old. Its doors are wide open to all the citizens of Hamilton, and it has something for everyone. The steel worker and the stenographer, the housewife and the businessman, the student and the little child. The older ones may find the steps a little difficult, and the eager young ones take them two at a time, but they all go in these doors, seek, and usually find the books and information they want.
Okay, we're ready.
Do you want me to do it then?
I just knocked over the print.
Okay, am I good?
To serve people who live more than a mile from any other library. As the outlying parts of the city become fully built up, new branches should be built. In the meantime, the Bookmobile is very popular. But one bookmobile can't serve every place where books are needed. So we look after the children by sending boxes of books to their classrooms. Students use atlases and encyclopedias. Young women consult etiquette books. Toddlers who can't read can still know and love books. Older children soon find out that the librarian will help them find the answer to a lot of their problems in books.
I gotta read a drama.
Jacob, do you want to unlock these for me, please? Thank you. Have a good day, Jacob. Thanks, Lisa.
No problem.
It's a flower.
Bye.
You say bye.
Okay, you say bye.
Bye-bye.
The library must keep pace with the growth of the city in order to serve all its citizens in the future as well as it does now.
Okay, so that was some of the fun shenanigans that are going on with the Hamilton Public Library Bookmobile, and I am honored to be a part of that organization to help provide books and DVDs for Hamilton.
Good for you, Bill.
Thanks.
It's a wonderful service.
And by the way, people, while you are watching that, the creeping band here came up with a piece of music to end the show off with. they wrote this and practiced it and basically ran through it one time. So, so what's this piece called?
We didn't have enough time to put a title to it or a name to it.
We call the song Untitled.
Untitled. And
because it takes longer.
We'll leave that up to you, Bill. You title it.
Okay. Well, I'm not going to title it. No, this is
your show, Bill.
This is your baby.
It's called You Can Write One Faster Than You Can Listen to It.
Okay, fine. But it's kind of like, it was a bit of East Indian sounding slightly.
Sometimes, yeah.
Very slight.
Sometimes. Highway 20.
That's kind of a surf bongra. Surf bongra.
Good one.
Surf bongra.
So I've no idea if anyone has any idea what a bongra is, but I'm sure some people might know. So let's put your amps on. Here you go. Here's the creeping bent. God bless you, Hamilton.
Exploring the splendor of James Street South. We're gonna have Cadillac Bill and Miss Chaos Divine teach us a brand new dance. And we're gonna have a whole lot of fun next time on the Cadillac Bill Show.
Set up.